Affordable high-speed internet for rural or hard-to-reach areas via laser beam. That's what Taara promises. The project started as an experiment by Google's parent company, Alphabet. Now, Taara is becoming an independent enterprise. Some see the tech rivaling Elon Musk's satellite internet company, Starlink, when it comes to connecting rural areas. Internet via laser? How's that supposed to work? And what's in it for you? Simply put, laser connectivity works similarly to fiber optic cables. Normally, data is transmitted through the cables, traveling from a server to an internet provider, for example. From there, the data reaches users either via more cables or through cellular towers. Instead of cables, Taara uses very narrow laser beams, about as thick as a pencil. They are sent via so-called light bridges, terminals the size of a traffic light. Other than our thumbnail suggests, the beams are invisible. We just wanted to visualize what we are talking about. The devices use small mirrors to precisely adjust the beam of light. According to Taara, this technology can bridge up to 20 kilometers, reaching speeds of up to 20 gigabits per second. To cover 100 kilometers, for example, you'd need 6 towers with Taara light bridges. Internet via laser is not new. Taara is the direct successor of another Google X project, Loon. From the late 2000s until 2021, researchers tried to provide internet to remote areas using fleets of balloons interconnected by laser beams. The balloon concept was discontinued, but the laser technology was further developed and is now being used in the Taara project. All right, but why do we need that? In 2024, an estimated 2.6 billion people had no access to the internet. That's about one-third of the world's population. One main reason: internet providers don't want to spend a lot of money on infrastructure to reach remote areas. Now, without having to lay or install kilometers of fiber cables, Taara offers a cheaper alternative. One example: in 2023, an undersea cable network connecting several Caribbean islands was damaged. An internet provider used Taara's technology to link the island of Anguilla with nearby St. Martin, 18 kilometers away. This reconnected 11,500 people in Anguilla to the internet. Another use case: Taara can amplify connectivity at big events. It was already successfully tested at the famous Coachella Festival in the US. By the way, Elon Musk's enterprise Starlink also offers laser internet, but via interconnected satellites whose signals can be received on Earth with special antennas. How do the two systems compare? Taara has one big advantage: it's much, much cheaper than Starlink. Starlink has also faced criticism over space junk. Right now, there are more than 7,000 Starlink satellites in orbit, potentially posing a threat to space travel. Another issue is bandwidth and speed. When Starlink satellites serve densely populated areas, the internet connection can slow down. Taara claims to provide much greater bandwidth than Starlink. How valid that statement is remains to be seen. However, it takes some time to install Taara connections over longer distances. Starlink satellites already cover large parts of the Earth. And Taara doesn't work everywhere. The laser beams can be disturbed by fog, for example, making it unsuitable for a city like San Francisco. Taara's developers say they have technology that can compensate for short interruptions like passing birds, but they acknowledge they can't operate perfectly everywhere. A coverage map has been released. Red means conditions are good. But there's another catch concerning both systems. For now, Google only holds a minority stake in Taara, but the company remains crucial as Taara expands. And Starlink is owned by the richest guy in the world. Elon Musk's company is unrivaled at the moment. Relying on big tech for internet connectivity could have long-term downsides. If one provider gains a monopoly, service quality could decline while prices go up. How's connectivity where you live? In case you need a better connection, which system would you rather use? Let us know.